So, hi guys, my name is Chandranshu Rathore. I'm a data analyst trainer at Skillected, and today we are going to talk about Power BI. So before Power BI, let's talk about what is BI. BI refers to business intelligence. Basically, it refers to the uses of technologies, practices, systems, and uses so that we are able to collect, analyze, and uncover our business insights. Okay, it helps a business to take informed decisions. Now let's talk about some key components of BI. They are data collection, data transformation, visualization, and support decision. You have to first collect data from different databases, cloud services, or let's say Excel spreadsheets. Then you have to transform your data for a better analysis. Then we transform, or let's say convert, our data in the form of charts, graphs, and tables. And finally, on basis of those charts, graphs, and tables, we make informed decisions. Now, Power BI is the Microsoft's most powerful BI tool, business intelligence tool. It basically helps users to make dashboards, make informed decisions, do data analysis, and uncover many, or let's say n number of insights from data. Okay, in Power BI, we get data. The workflow of Power BI, let's just talk about that. First, we have to get data from different sources. Then we have to, let's say, analyze that data and create some data modeling on basis of our data. After that, we have to clean, transform, visualize, and then finally, we have to create a report or insight in our dashboard. Okay, it's like giving a canvas for a storytelling. Okay, you put all of your data onto a canvas and you can just simply explore all of those insights using Power BI. Now, let's talk about the interface. We have this Power BI interface on our screen. Now, this interface is divided into three panes. Now, what are these three panes? We have first our view pane that simply have a different view. First is report view, table view, we have model view, and we have a text query view. Second, we have our canvas area. Now, onto this canvas area, we are going to create all of our reports. ये जो हमारा canvas area है, हम हमारे सारे reports यहाँ पर build up करने वाले हैं. ठीक है? Then we have a filter pane, which is basically used to apply filters onto our visual. Then we have visualization pane, and after that we have our data pane, which simply helps us to get our data in front of us. Okay, just like every other Microsoft tool, we have a ribbon with us. हमारे पास एक ribbon है, जहाँ से हम बहुत सारे options या फिर let's say जहाँ से हम बहुत सारे tools इन सबको access कर सकते हैं. We have different tabs like home, insert, modeling, view, optimize, help, which helps us for different types of analysis, or we can say different types of work execution. Okay. So we have this report view. Through the report view page, you are able to view your report. Like you can simply view your canvas, like what is your canvas, and you can simply get on this view where you will spend your 90% of your time. ये एक ऐसा view है जहाँ पर आप अपना 90% of the time spend करते हैं. You are going to spend 90% of the time onto this canvas area. After that, we have our table view. Now table view is simply used so that you are able to view your data in the table format, like in the format of rows and columns. Then we have our model view, like we can see many relationships created in there. If we have like more than one data sources, if we have let's say three tables, four tables, or five tables, or five data sources, so we can create relationship between them and present them here. Then we have DAX query view. It helps us to get some advanced analysis. Like if you are familiar with SQL queries, you can simply write DAX query. Now DAX queries are somewhat different than SQL queries. Okay. These are our different visualizations. Like we can simply just click onto a visualization, it will like display on our screen, and what we have to do, then we have to only select the data for that. Now let's get some data and practice on it. You can get the sample data from Power BI also, or if you want to extract your own data, you can extract your own data. I have this file called Power BI Essentials, so let's work on this. Okay, so this is how you can simply get data. Now, I totally forgot about very one most important thing inside Power BI. Let's just close this and let me just tell you about that first. Okay, do you know how many data sources we can import data from inside Power BI? I would like you to take a guess. How many? See, some of you are thinking mostly 10, 20, 30, 40. But if I just present you on my screen, you can extract your data from n number of sources. Let's say whether it's a file data, whether it's Excel, CSV, XML, JSON, folder, PDF, Paracet, SharePoint folder, whether it's a database. Okay, now we have different SQL Server database, we have Access, we have SQL Server Analysis, Oracle, IBM, MySQL, Postgres, Sybase, Teradata. If it's a big database, let's say SAP HANA, Amazon Redshift, Impala, Google BigQuery, Snowflake, Sbase, everything is there. Whether you want to get data from Microsoft Power, Microsoft Fabric platform, let's say we have DataMart, Warehouse, Lakehouse, whether it's a Power platform, whether they are Azure services, you can get data from all of these services at the very free of cost. We have some other services as well. Okay, so there are not 20, 30, but there are many n number of sources from where you can simply extract data and you can uncover those insights inside Power BI. So let's get data from Excel book first. We are going to import this Power BI Essential file. Okay, now onto your screen, we have these two options. Either I can get this data table, like we have this option of table, which is written as table one, and we have a sheet. Now, as you can see, there are two different icons. So mostly we work on the tables. Why? Because table are structured data format. The data is in a structured format of rows and columns, and all my data is basically specified. So we are going to load this data because for the dates table, we don't have a table. For the dates sheet, we don't have a table. So we are going to simply import the dates sheet. Let's load this data. I will directly load this data as there are not that much of transformation to be done on this data. So let's talk about the introduction and what are the basic works that we can simply do with Power BI. Okay, so creating, we can say, visuals inside Power BI is not that much of a difficult. You just simply have to select your visual, and after selecting your visual, you just have to simply import the data in there. Okay, now I'm going to take this table view. As I said, inside table view, you are able to view your data in the table format. So we have this data dates and we have this table one. Okay, inside model view, we can simply create relationship between them. Let me just create a relationship between these two tables on basis of a common column, that is date. Okay, now let's create some basic visualizations. We can create some basic visual. Let's say if I want to create a clustered column chart, I can create a clustered column chart. I just simply have to select a chart. Now what kind of data I want to reflect? Let's say I want to see sales as per my beverage brand. So what I have to do, I just simply have to drag this beverage brand onto the x-axis and all my, let's say, units sold onto the y-axis. So we can see the beverage brands units sold as per, like, according to different brands. We have Coca-Cola, Dasani Water, Diet Coke, Sprite, Fanta, Powerade. Okay, let's suppose if I want to do any other kind of visualization on my screen, so I can do that as well. I can just simply select this clustered column chart again, and this time I want to see my unit sold as per different states. So I will select states. I can just simply click that also, or I can drag them into the x-axis also. Okay, and I want to see the unit sold as per that. So here it is. So for these states, the most, like, chart we use when we have a regional data, we have to use, or let's say we use mostly the map chart or filled map chart. So what we are going to do, I'm going to select this map chart onto my screen and I will just simply select my states. So states will be there on the location. As you can see, every state is highlighted as per their locations. We have Oregon, Washington, Idaho, Wyoming, Montana, North Dakota, South Dakota. We have Nebraska, Colorado, New Mexico, Arizona, California, Arkansas, Louisiana, Mississippi, everything. And I want to see what's the unit sold according to that. So I'm going to put them in bubble size. As you can see, my states are reflected in the bubbles, that blue circle, we can say. These are called bubbles. As I add the unit sold, so according to the value, these values will be highlighted, and according to the value, the bubble size will be defined. Okay, we can do many things inside. Let's say if I want to change any kind of map settings, I can do that as well. I can select a road, or I can want to select the aerial chart. So this looks more realistic and more dynamic. So we can do that as well. Okay, so these are some of the basics of Power BI. Like, this is how you can create some basic charts and some let's say basic visualizations. If you want to create a table also, we can create a table also. Okay, so as for the beginning, I just showed you like what is Power BI and what are these three panes and everything is for, and how you can do basic visualization. If I want to create, let's say, a table, I can create a table as well. Here we have a table, and according to that table, I can see the units sold also. So these are some of the things that you can perform with Power BI. So for the next session, be tuned with Skillected, press that bell icon, and please press that subscribe button, let's say, for more updates and new videos. And if you want to also, let's say, get the updates of our latest reels and all the shortcuts and hacks, do follow Skillected on Instagram and do follow us on YouTube. Thank you so much, guys.